we go to work, and no matter what happens at work that day, we're working to make the world a better place, a safer place for kids and for adults and parents. And that in and of itself is also incredibly rewarding. The catalyst for what we're doing today really started when my daughter, who's competing now as well, took a shot to her head and crumpled, essentially just went down. And between my wife asking me, did she have a concussion, and my mom asking me, did she have a concussion, and not having an answer because there was no diagnostic test to tell us for sure if she had a concussion, it really sort of became frustrating. I thought, here we are, we can do all these incredible things with technology and in medicine, but we can't diagnose this condition, which all our kids are at risk for who are, playing in athletics, but even just slip and falls and car accidents. And it's crazy that we have no diagnostic tools. And that was sort of the moment that I thought, maybe I should do something here. If you don't have objective data, you're sort of trying to find the answer, but you're really doing a lot of sort of licking your thumb and sort of, EQ provides that data. It provides the ability for a clinician to say, this is how Sanjeev is on any given day, on a day that, he's had travel all week, or a day that he's been fighting a cold all week. This is his variability. He's just had a collision, and his scores now are remarkedly different. And in doing that, we brought, some of the best sort of neurosurgeons, neurologists, sports medicine physicians together with really world-class mathematicians who could run mathematical models to tell us, how much data did we need to truly know there was a difference. And then we fused it together with, a world-class gaming studio, a company that had been award-winning, had, millions of downloads of their games, to have a tool that would be engaging for the user, at the same time leveraging the strength of mathematics and machine learning and diagnostics. We thought there's no way people were going to do this test if it was heavy duty, sort of medicalized. But if we can make it fun and we could sort of make it engaging, and what if, a team of sort of girls volleyball team or boys basketball team actually started to compete with each other and see who get the highest score, which we have seen at tournaments where kids will actually compete for the highest score. Now it's fun. Now it's not a test. Now it's not, the doctor needs something. Now it's, can I beat my friend's highest score? And kids like that. Adults like that. I like that. I'm still trying to beat my highest score.